If you like this video, why not subscribe? So this is my basic screen layout in Sony Vegas Pro. The first thing people have asked me about is how I got my timeline on the top here, because the default for Sony Vegas now, I think since version 9, has been the timeline on the bottom and all these dockable windows on top. Well, that was not the original configuration of Sony Vegas, or Vegas, back when it was owned by Sonic Foundry, since I've been using it since version 4. But if you want to reverse this or get it back to the original Vegas layout, you can, actually, I've got the old version here, but if you want to switch it back to the new version, you can click on Options, go to Preferences, click on the Display tab, and then there's a box right here that says Display Timeline at bottom of main window. Click that, check it, hit OK, and here you have the current Sony Vegas layout, which, in my opinion, the reason they went to this was because it resembled Final Cut Pro and Premiere Pro, so in order to make it maybe more competitive, or allow people to say, hey, it looks like that other editor, or so now it's more respectable, I don't know. But I don't like that, I prefer the original layout, so thankfully Sony allows me to restore the original layout by unchecking this box and doing this. Now on the bottom you have various dockable windows which you can access through the View menu that will allow you to turn various things on, and I'm not going to go through all of those, but I'm going to show you what I use. This is my typical layout right here. Starting on the left, let's see if I can get this box back. Let me do that. Starting on the left here, we have our master volume, or our main levels, so that when you play your audio, here I don't want to make that too loud, when you play your audio there, you can see how the meters go up and down. They're very responsive, they're really good, so, and since this program started out as an audio editor, I'm glad they maintained whatever audio tools they have for it, because it's great. Those are your meters. Here you've got your global or master effects button, which you can add an effect, an audio effect to everything all at once in your project. The most important thing that I think you will always use, or I always use with your global effects button, is wave hammer surround. And what that is basically a limiter. It'll limit how high your audio can go, so it'll never clip or go off the charts. It doesn't mean if you have bad audio it'll fix it, it just means that it won't go above a certain level, which you can set here. Negative 12 dB is kind of the general standard, so that's what I've got mine set at. Another thing you should know about these dockable windows is these six dots right here. When you hold your mouse button down on those six dots and drag, it'll unlock whatever you've got docked, so make it a free-floating window. That's just important to know if you didn't know that already. Next up we've got the video preview right here, and I try and make mine to fill in this little space as much as possible. There we go. No way, I wasn't set like that before. Anyway, that's the video preview. Again, you can turn it on in the View menu. Most important thing here, well, you've got your grid here you can use for your safe title and make sure things are within broadcast limits, but for the web, I usually disregard that pretty much. Actually, I guess I use the outside wireframe there for guidance. But here you have another global effects tab. If you want to apply something to a whole project, I don't really use that often because I tend to do things on an individual clip basis. So that is that. Here's those dots again if you want to unlock it and float it around. Here is a snapshot. Something I didn't mention in the freeze frame video is this is a very simple way to get a still frame too, is to do it this way. This is in every version of Vegas. But I use the velocity method quite often, so I forgot to mention that, but a lot of people brought it up in the comments. Glad they did. Next up, we have a really important box. This is your video scopes box. And if you're unfamiliar with video scopes, these are all of them. If you've ever taken any kind of broadcast class, you may recognize these. Your vector scope, waveform monitor, histogram, RGB parade. All these things can be used in color correction and video signal correction. I usually have waveform turned on. That's what I use the most. And if you're wondering, hey, how do I adjust this? There's no effects button. What do I do if I want to adjust my video signal? I'll show you in just a second here. First, I want to mention that, you know, 100% is pure white and 0 is pure black. Typically, your signal, you want it to be around 80% as far as the whites go. If you go above 100%, it's going to clip. If you go below 0, then it's really black. But if you want to increase your contrast level, you do need to dip it below 0 a little bit. That always looks better. But to adjust this, you want to go to your effects tab on your video over here, and there we go. I've got a color corrector installed here, and also levels. And notice here, See, I'll get this out of the way so you can see it a little better. When I adjust these various sliders on levels, you'll move that video signal up and down. And I'm not going to go through these individually. I mean, you can play with them and see what they do, but notice you can make your the upper end go up and down and the lower end go down below zero. Like I said, and notice when that waveform gets flat on the bottom, that's called crushing the blacks. That's when your blacks are really, really black. And you can do that for various effects. As you can see, the contrast goes way crazy when I do stuff like that. But so I typically put it just a little bit below zero. When you upload to YouTube, it'll actually add a little more contrast. So you need to be aware of that so you don't crush the blacks too much, because YouTube will crush them more. But that's how you adjust this signal right here. Very, very important, very handy to see what you're getting. And if you're wondering what the difference is, like I said, I forgot to show you when I turn off levels. Notice how the waveform changes because I've already adjusted it. Finally, we have this box over here, which is all your various other tools. I have Project Media set up. That's where you import everything. And you can also add folders here by right-clicking on Media Bins. You can create new bin and have folders. I usually have a video bin, audio bin, and a stills bin, which I don't have here at the time, but that's normally what I go for. But everything else, these tabs will control or allow you to switch to Trimmer, Explorer, your transitions video, effects, whatever you got set up down there. So that's the basic layout that I use for Sony Vegas. This is a Pro 10 version. Like I said, it's an editor I really like. And you don't have to do this, of course. You can set up any way you want. It's really flexible, but that's my basic layout. Game over.